Welcome to the fourth sofa session, a reflection on week three about defining a design challenge. It's great to see all your activity in the forums. We are recognizing some names already and enjoy following your progress. Unfortunately, I cannot have a look at every single post and piece of work that you upload. There are simply too many students and my time is limited. And that's why we have the peer feedback. From prior courses, we know that participants are sometimes disappointed about the feedback that they receive. First, because links do not work, so there's nothing for the peers to assess. And secondly, because the feedback they receive is very poor. What to do? For the peer feedback upload, we recommend you that you upload files with the compatible format to edX and to avoid using links to other platforms or websites. This is because some participants cannot use your chosen platform in their country and or their internet connection is too low. For the feedback part, okay, this was just your first experience and there are two more peer assessments to come, so you will have another chance to practice peer reviewing. I would like to encourage you again to do your best to make the feedback as useful as you can for your peers. It helps to find answers for the following three questions. Is the content clear? Do I understand it? Is the content relevant? Is it according to the assignment? And is it well presented? Is it attractive with text and visualizations? For each answer, you can give some tips and some tops, as explained in the prior sofa session, a reflection on week two. A video about peer feedback is under construction and will be uploaded next week. Now let's have a look at some examples. Okay, we are here in a drawing studio and this is specifically for automotive. And I start with the work of Yazid. I think this is a very nice and detailed result of the design challenge. The persona, the person, is very detailed described. And now it's for children, and that fits the persona Skila Dahilin. And what I also like a lot about it is the preliminary requirements. They are clustered, so it's very clear to read them. They're full sentences, and some of them, they are already measurable, because that's also important for requirements, that you can that you later on know how to assess your concept, that it's not too vague what you hear describe. So, for example, localization should be operatable in English-speaking child who fits the persona. Yeah, this is something you can check at the end. This is also a nice example of Xu Liang for a careless morning owners. So it's not focusing on one person, but more in a general way. And here you have the full sentences explaining what the product, the concept should do. Well done. When we look at the work at Elena, is also nice presented with visuals. What I like about this example is that she's using a metaphor. A metaphor is actually emphasizing the meaning that you want to evoke with your product. And yeah, for her it's Superman. I like also to show you the work of DC, because I think it's a very challenging design challenge. He or she is focusing on the transition of a person's morning ritual. So I think it's a very creative idea to say, okay, it's for young people who change their lives. They're going to live in from their family life to student life. And the aim is to support this person in the transition. And I'm really curious what will come out. Some constraints are missing, And maybe you constrain could be that the young adult's budget that is limited. Also for the preliminary requirements, a comment from my side is be careful that you don't make your task too difficult as a designer. So if you have requirements that are very difficult to meet, then you make it yourself a hard time. At the same time, you need to be specific, your requirements should be measurable, and you should distinguish the goal that you want to achieve from the more specific requirements. This is an example of Ajit, and he is actually focusing on a specific way of bathing, the bucket bath, and to avoid spoiling water. And so there is already a little bit a notion of a context. And yeah, maybe actually here we could have add also the where. Where is your product? Where will your product will be used? Say a little bit more about that. We are very happy to see that you already have discussions in the forums about the context and that that there are differences all over the world. And I would like to conclude that you try to be as specific as possible about the context and also about the formulation of your requirements. Maybe some of you now feel the need to do more research. And yes, indeed, usually we spend much more time on that. Usually all kinds of new questions will pop up. You easily can lost in all kinds of sub-studies. The art of design is also to deal with uncertainties and assumptions. The deadlines are used to help to make decisions. And for this course, you can do some quick desktop research. You can search for topics of interest to find text and pictures to inform and inspire you. And then a final note. The team feature is ready. You can choose a topic and within a topic you can form teams or create a new team. Tip, introduce yourself in one of the teams with an upload of your design challenge. So that's it for now, and I wish you a lot of fun with the generation of ideas.